This is all Home Depot's fault. I went there the other day and saw what they were charging for 10-foot, 3/4-inch metal conduit pipe. In Canada, we often pay twice as much as Americans do for things, so $385 for 10 feet of metal conduit really caught my attention. Instantly, I thought, score! So I bought 36 pieces, enough to make a 200-square-foot, 2V geodesic dome greenhouse frame. This video series will follow how I'm building a four-season greenhouse as economical as possible for Manitoba winters. SimpleTech, technology, agriculture, and energy videos. Hitting the subscribe button tells YouTube these are the kind of videos you want to see more of. Click the subscribe button now. So I took the 10-foot conduit pipes and measured them using an online geodesic 2V dome calculator. One cut, no waste, two pieces from one, using a simple grinder and a vise to hold the pipe. Next, I put all the pipes together on the ground and verified I had cut them all to the same length. I was quite impressed that they all lined up almost perfectly. I marked 1.5 inches on each side with a Sharpie marker as a guide so I'd know how far to squish the end of each pipe. Then I used one of the pipes as a ruler to draw my 1.5-inch line across all of them in one big swipe. Voila! All marked and ready to go to the squisher. Okay, the technical name is something like hydraulic press, but I really like the term squisher. That just works for me, so you're going to hear me call it that quite a bit from now on. So after marking all the pipes, I turned on the squisher and was really impressed at how easily this tool flattened the ends of the pipes. Much better than trying to do this with a vise or a hammer. It's very important to have the other side squished on the same level plane as the first side, so I rigged up a way to ensure when squishing both sides were level to each other. Next, I used a Sharpie to mark the ends with a dot to show where to drill the bolt holes, 3/4 inch from the end of each side of the pipes. The drill press made putting the bolt holes in easy. I couldn't imagine how much harder this would be with a regular drill. Precision and speed happen when you have the right tools. Or at least know the right people to borrow the right tools from. Of course, there are some metal shavings on the drilled holes, so using a big mounted grinder is essential if you want the pipe ends to fit together snugly. It's quick and easy to grind off the shavings from both ends of the pipes. The angle of the pipe ends is extremely important on a geodesic dome. One pipe is supposed to be 18 degrees, the other 16 degrees. Using a roofer's protractor, I found the squisher made them all about 16 to 18 degrees. Distinguishing 1 or 2 degrees from that was almost impossible. So I'm hoping on assembly of the dome, I can easily bend the couple of degrees necessary to complete the dome. That's it for this video. All pipes measured, cut, squished, drilled, grinded, and angles verified. In the next video, I'll show how I assembled the dome. Thank you for watching, and please take a moment to hit the subscribe button. Hitting subscribe tells YouTube to suggest to you more videos about technology, agriculture, and energy. Thank you for watching.